you could get. Now, I never did draw no money over there, but he drawed his pay all the time. But hell, an hour or two after he got it, when he'd be broke, he'd call me. He loved to shoot them dice. And some of them guys just sit around waiting on him. He'd put me in old haze a lot of time with him. My God, we had to keep the road open. That was our job, to keep the road open. They'd give a damn whatever happened to a tank or a truck or get the son of a bitch out of the way so the rest of them could get through. We'd turn them over on the road and everything else.
Did he make it all the way through? Did Hayes make it all the way through?
I left before he did. I don't know whatever happened to him. I never did hear from him after that. I know that you had to have so many points, but the Germans was over. If you didn't have a certain amount of points, you went to Japan. Now, if we could get a raid, that way. They kept trying to get me old Hayes to go, and I said, hell no. I remember one old colonel told me, he said, if you and I, he said, I got 4 or 5 men more, go over there with me and get set up. Everything said, you'll be on the first plane home. I'll make sure you're on the first plane home. I said, I'm going to be on the first boat. I can't always go to Japan. You had to have so many points. I don't know what it was, a year of service. How many battles you said? Battle stars. You had so many points. Then I believe it was either 5 or 9 points per star, and I had, I think you got 6 or 9, I don't remember. And how many years of service you was in and all that and everything. Anyway, it had to add up to 60 for you to be eligible to go home instead of the other way. I think I had almost 90. I did, yeah. Yeah, old Colonel, he knew I was going home. But it did come around later. We were in Spa, Belgium a little while. We were in and out of the Battle of the Bulge. I can't remember what was come back to Spa, Belgium to do something and then head back. Just be there a few days, you know, or maybe 2 or 3 days. And, a damn soldier always had a woman in my house, you know. And so this old colonel come around after that, and we were just there waiting on the ship before we went to No Asma, east side of the British Isles with the dummy army. And they felt sure that Patton was going to be leading the invasion, you know. But they let them let some airplane get through once in a while and take pictures of old Patton's army there. They had plastic tanks, they had plastic everything, there, tons of them. They just knew that it was going to be up there on that, next to the Rhine River, and the shit was down to the other end. Bradley was actually in charge of the invasion, and as soon as he got it all spotted up, he was there, they turned over to Patton loose in there. Made another army, made the 3rd army.
When they was moving them around over there, would you end up walking or did you ride or what did you do?
Both. Or whatever.
I They move slow enough you can walk, keep up with them?
Well, that's just a bit when you're sitting close and everything, you know. You didn't drive right up to them in a Jeep or a truck, you know. How far enough? But no, they drive. Black boys was always in charge of the, call that supply line going from Normandy and the Jeep all the way to Paris there. They call that the Red Ball Line. But nothing else allowed on that road except them. Black boys, all they were truck drivers, and they'd have whole damn companies of them, you know. They'd haul supplies to the front, gasoline to the front and everything, and prisoners back. They talk about how mean the soldiers was to the Americans. Well, they wasn't nobody any meaner than the goddamn American soldiers. Well, they wasn't, but you never heard nothing about that. It was all propaganda, you know. Them black boys would come in there, them were where they'd have a bunch of them German prisoners and unload your gasoline or whatever, you know, and they put them prisoners in the back of a 6x truck, standing up. They'd take and push them in there to get one more in there. Then they'd take out under some low lamps. where they couldn't duck, they so damn thick they couldn't duck below the limb or nothing. You know? I don't know whether they did it all the time or not, but I see them doing it once or twice.
Mohawk Indian, he lost him the other day. I thought all of them were Navajos.
I did too. That's what I started saying. I thought they were Navajos.
They said he was a Mohawk, I thought.
Well, the Navajo, there's another reservation up there pretty close to Mohawk. Yeah, they had them all fooled with that. Them Indians could talk back and forth and nobody knew who the hell they were. Never heard of them.
Wonder who came up with that idea.
Well, I don't know. That's a
pretty sharp idea, really.
Well, it means most of them done it in the Pacific. Must have been MacArthur or one of the generals. What did you used to call that? To keep a
that starter dough?
Starter. Starter. She said, no, I don't have to keep no starters today. Yeah, all them kind of people used to keep a starter. God damn, I can't think of none of that fish. Yeah, we go back in there to that country and hunt. Never did worry about getting caught because all of Wyee County, southwest of the Snake River, is Wyee County, just about. And he knew the game warden. And the game warden told me one time, I was just talking to him down there in Grandview. I wasn't saying anything about hunting. I'd done it through his garage, where he run a little garage. He said, hell, I ain't going to arrest nobody for no license or hunting out of season. They can go do whatever the hell they want to. Because I'm not going to make an ass out of myself. That's what he said. He said, there ain't no damn well in Wyee County you can find 12 people and convict somebody of hunting out license. He said, I know better than that to even go to court.
Oh,
we go back in there, I'd kill a bunch of quail and chuck them. And Billy Jean would cook them. Whatever the hell.
Would Junior go with you?
Yeah, but he didn't hunt. He'd go around with me and everything, but he probably couldn't hit his bull's ass no way because he never did hunt. He fish some. I can't think of the name of them fish. Them kind of big fish. What are they in the water? They're big solid fishes. They're not salmon, but...
Big gar?
No, they're not gars. They're good to eat, but I mean they get up 50 pounds, maybe even 100 pounds. And he would catch them and take them over to Silver City. There's a Silver City there pretty close to them, too, you know, and sell them and trade them for fruit and stuff. And that Snake River blow that dam out to our house. These pools there, the bag got it deep, you know. And he got one hooked one time, and it got hung up on the bottom. He's lying dead, and he couldn't get it out. It'd take you maybe a half a day or more to get him out, you know. He's so damn big. By God, he went in after us, so Miss my daughter got that line untangled. Come out of there with her, I forget what kind of fish them is, but they can really get big. And what's the name of that river? Comes down below their dam. It's the same one we stay on there.
Snake?
Yeah, Snake. Snake right below our house, you know. And there were some big pools down there. Deep pools, not big and wide or anything, but they're deep. And that's where they was. I can't think of the name of them big fish, but they get big. They're not doing it yet.
Junior's what?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, she's in a nursing home in Mountain Home.
Is she?
Yeah. We stopped her to see her first. No, we stopped her. That was next year. The next year we stopped there to see Billie Jean. And she wasn't home. And Jim, what was the oldest boy's name? Anyway, he was living in the house. He took the house over and she was in a home in Mountain Home, but we didn't know at that time. He runs a bar there in Grandview. We went to the bar to check with him, see where she was, and then the bartender told us where Billie Jean was, and he told us he was in a nursing home, but he didn't know where or anything about it, but he knew she was in a nursing home. John was there with Snake. He was gone to Boise that day, so we couldn't see him. So we just went on, and then after that we called
what was her daughter's name? Susie.
Susie.
Yeah.
But the other one of mine is, I forget what her name was. He lived down the highway there. Her husband, he was a county roadman over the old county road. And he got something in his dick, and he'd just be driving along, and he'd go blind. And maybe run off a damn road or anything, you know, and they had to retire. And he was Randy is his name, and they come up there below the river there and stay where we do up there and hunt horns. And you'd be surprised at the damn elk horns and deer horns they find. They make. She last time I was talking to her, she said we've got a load up. There's a Boy Scout camp in Jackson, and they get the first crack at it. They got so many days, and at the end of about 30 days, and at the end of those 30 days, then anybody can hunt. And she says that you'd be surprised how many antlers we got. And Randy, he was really good at mounting something. What is it called?
Taxidermist?
Yeah. He was really good at that. He never had to have any trouble, but he did all of his own. He's got a room. He's got about any kind of damn animal in that room. They did it all himself. And he even wanted to grouse. And I told Junior I'd mail him a grouse. I mailed him two grouse from Kentucky. And Junior said when he walked in the post office, he knew he was there because I could smell him. But he mailed it. He's got it in the room. One of them. The other one was about it. I've been wanting to stop. Elian seen him. He was in the hospital in the bed. Leola was there. I'd called Leola the day before and told her he was going to stop seeing him. She told us he was in the hospital where it was. And so we stopped her and went in. Leola was there. Mace, he just barely didn't know us. He was pretty sick and he died 2 weeks later.
Huh.
Stay where I had left. You know that generator there and run that something in my driveway, but over here. Up too high, I guess. But it tells you in the instructions on them so much as all that they'll have effect on them, that's right. I know outboard motors when we used to go up in northern Utah or Montana, they're up at Mountain Lake where we always used. Test gasoline. I remember Mason was having a hell of a time here. It was a little while and just quit. A little while and quit. And I told him, well, I said, I asked him in, what kind of gasoline you got? And he said, I just got it. Well, that kind of, not a good thing in town. He said, I asked him, what he put in? He said, breaker. I said, well, dump that damn stuff out and put you in some high test. You won't have any more problems. He did, and he didn't have any more fun. Just wouldn't run on it. Up that high, that's, I don't know, that's 5,000 or 6,000 feet to it. That's like old Ben next door to me, one before he died way back young, when I first got mine. My heater, I forget what kind they are. They're propane, but in there. But then you can lay your hand on them and it won't burn you. But then the heat comes right out. And it'll take the chill off of it. Actually, if you go to heat it up, it'd be two of them. You want to put up your bedroom. But that would take the chill off of it all the time. I forget what they call them here. They're propane. And they're no flame, no nothing like that. You just light them. Get red. You lay your hand on it, won't burn you. And no flame about them or anything. It's a ray heat. Goes out whatever it hits.
Yeah.
And I think some of this cost about $300. And old Ben, I was telling him about it, he was just wanting to get in, I'd already put water pumps in for him, got out or what else. He was talking about getting him one of them. I told him what they cost. He said, oh, hell, I'm going to get one of them tonight. Catalytic heaters is what they are. And I said, well, that's what I want to do the job for me. He come in one day and he told me, said, I got me one of them catalytic heaters. I said, you did? Yeah. I said, he called it at, what's them discount stores?
Or dollar store or something?
Harbor Freight. He bought it at Harbor Freight. And he said, boy, did I get a good price on it. I said, you did? I said, what did you pay for it at Harbor Freight, man? He said, I think I paid $45 for it. I said, you did? And I said, what kind is it? He told me, I said, you ain't going up on the rent? He said, yeah, why? I said, you're a heater. Might as well stick it in your ass because it won't work up there. He said, what are you talking about? I said, did you read what come with that heater? He said, no. I said, you better read it, see what it said. He went back over the house and read the heater. Well, he come back over and said, oh, damn, you're right. That damn thing won't even work up there, won't it? I said, hey, some of them won't even burn up to 5,000. I think 4,000 feet is the limit. That's the reason this kind of here, this kind of what kind of I got cost too much. He took it back. Not in the joint or anything, but just right there. I can rub something. I use that a couple of days and then.
Oh, I tell you, I laid there on the couch the next day. I just kept it straight, and then finally I started getting strength back into it.
How'd you hurt?
I was walking down a steep bank, and this leg went straight out. And this one went right back underneath. And I landed right on it. I didn't think anything of it at the time. But I got back up on it and it seemed pretty good. And we were about halfway. I was about halfway through 203. We got up to the end of 203 and everybody aired up and everything. We fooled around there. And the time I got down off the mountain there and back, about the Spring Creek store, but he was starting to stiff up. That's when I stopped at your place and got some stuff and made it on home.
She had to go to the valley for something, or a doctor or hearing aids or whatever. And I believe it was her hearing aids. She had to go down and get her. So I don't know. I can't remember, but I know she had to go to the valley.
Yeah. When she got back, y'all were leaving.
Yeah.
What do you want? You ready to go in the house? No bark. No bark. I gave you all his treats.
You what?
But you gave her all the treats. Didn't you?
Yes.
You want all the treats. You want inside?
Let's go inside.
You want inside? For the wind to be blowing.
No.
This time of year for this campground is beautiful. It's hot all over but here. Underneath the shade tree.
If we had had lawn chairs with us for the picnic, we'd still be there.
Yeah, you're right. Yeah. It was the ideal spot, too.
Oh, wow. That was beautiful. Yeah.
jack start out, yeah. That's the other jack start out. They like you never got across the damn road. We sat there.
We sat there. Yes, we did. Watched them. They was doing this, waiting for them. And they went from the water on up to the mountain. They came from the water on up. They must have been eating the grass down there at the bottom. And then one of our friends has goats, and he raises goats. And there's a big field on over on by Butcher Hook. Down in the valley before you get to Butcher Hook. You can't see it from the road, only you know it's the little road there. He raises goats in there. And he had the Forest Service ask him to borrow his goats for eating all underneath the bushes. Yeah. So there's a market for them. Want to go to bed? Mm-hmm.
You know that plug you use to plug into the cigarette lighter?
Yeah.
You can get them. They have two outlets in.
Yeah.
You can put two cords into it.
Yes, I got two or something. So I don't have to.
Good girl. They don't.
You're a pretty girl.
At home, if it's down, I don't even plug it in the house. I just plug it in the truck, right? Maybe sometime during the day, if I think about it.
Be nice to have it charged when you hit the road.
It'll be, you plug it into that truck, it talk like right there, don't give a damn if it's dead.
It really does. But you know what the kids all have? They have a ball, and they have something on a key ring, and they have something else that they take with them, and that charges them right now.
I've got a I've got two devices in there, nothing but batteries.
Charge the battery.
But I plugged his in that hot box yesterday.
I don't know why it is, but it seems to be like it charged three times faster than that truck before we plugged it in the whole thing. I don't know what it is.
Well, you aren't going through that inverter, you're plugging it straight in with that cord, aren't you? Plug it in with the cord. You don't put that plug in, do you? You plug it in the. You use that plug in your truck too?
No, it's got another top plug on it. That's
not all. Just take your cord that plugs into the phone, take the cord, and then plug the other end into your.
About 12 volt.
But you don't have a two-prong thing to plug it into, do you?
It's a 12-volt cigarette lighter plug.
Oh. That's why I plugged you into yesterday.
There's two of them in there.
He's all the time at me, Peter.
What are you filming there now?
I'm just charging. I haven't used it for a while, so I'm charging.
Thursday, and then come home Friday. She goes to the doctor Tuesday, to the new breast surgeon, and the pathologist will have all the information there to find out if it's. She's going to have to take all her lymph glands, I know. Find out whether it's any place else. Anyways, there's a lot to be done before anything will happen, probably.
So what are you doing, Snook? Huh?
Leave her alone and she'll leave you alone.
That's hard. I can't do it. I can't do it.
What are you doing, Snooky?
I'm smelling. Somebody dropped something, I know.
Or something to eat.
Looking for a cool place to lay, somebody to give me a breeze. Oh. No, there really isn't. Just different scenery we get to see. Yeah.
See more elk going this way.
Really, how much time we want to spend.
Go a different way.
Yeah. I'm going to spend. It is hot enough that part of the day. What is she eating? What do you got to
rock.
Huh?
Look at the rock.
Charlie did not eat it either, so don't
feel bad. I wasn't hungry. I was just going to fix it for you guys.
Yeah.
I ate a big breakfast this morning. I don't know about you.
I wasn't really hungry either.
Yeah, he had French toast. Bacon and French toast.
Did he eat that French toast?
Yes, he did.
What did he do?
With a half a bucket of syrup.
What do you do? I put it in the microwave first?
No. It doesn't matter. He eats a lot of things cold.
He ate that butt. Bacon too?
Yeah. Well, I don't know. Maybe Suki did. I don't know.
You gave my bacon away?
Did you feed Suki the bacon?
I split it.
He shared. Suki shared.
Well, I'll tell you what. You got me pretty close to 2,000 miles on the highway. I come up here to run dirt roads. I spent all this time driving highways.
I don't know. We did a few dirt roads. A few bumpies, huh?
Yeah.
A few dumps now and then.
First day and a half.
Yeah.
Well, first day was enough for me, let alone a half.
Oh.
I don't like them damn rocky roads.
It wasn't rocky roads that got you, it's that cliff that got you.
Let's just put it this way then, I don't like the road we're on, rocky or not rocky.
Look at what the campground looks like. We're right here in these pines. Of course, that's Dad's rig. That's a little renegade that takes me everywhere. We got these red cliffs in back of us. And then we got this view in front of us. Road coming down off Bryce Canyon, up to Bryce Canyon. It's a pretty nice spot here. Most of the time it's usually about 75 to 80, and it's really nice in these pines and the cool and stuff. And of course, there's our dinner table. I cook breakfast and dinner. The drives we took, it was just kind of a spur of the moment. It was a drive up north to an area called Fish Lake National Forest. It's up about 10,000 feet, and it's a huge lake up there. I couldn't believe how big the lake was. One of Dad's old buddies used to camp up there and fish up there, and he'd never been up there, and so he wanted to go up and see it. We went up there. There's a ton of camping grounds. Just a gorgeous area, but I'll tell you what, it's up on top of a mountain, that's for sure. And coming back down the other side, we seen a lot of cattle. It's all open range in there. It was amazing how beautiful it was, the green grass and stuff at that high. The drives we took that really surprised me was a drive we went up north to Fish Lake. So, we just got back from going over to Zion. This has been a full 7 days, I'll tell you. I left Phoenix to now, I put about 2,000 miles on the car. We've drove dirt trails, we've drove highways, we've been into Capitol Reef, Bryce Canyon, Cedar Breaks, Zion, as far as National Parks. And we drove the Smoky Mountain Road, which is about 78 miles of dirt road. We went up to Pine Lake. We've been down Cottonwood Canyon. We went down to Johnson Canyon. And just to get a better picture of Cottonwood Canyon, we drove that one again, coming the opposite way, so you can see it from both sides. It really looked different. I'm glad we did that. That's a beautiful drive up through there.